Ask two people who are completely familiar with shotguns and shotgun slugs whether or not a Foster slug fired out of a smoothbore shotgun actually spins or not, and you'll probably get two different answers. I recently posed this question on a very active Facebook group called Shotgun Nation, and the answers that people gave me were all over the place. No, they don't spin. Yes, they do spin. And some people actually started citing certain websites. Now, one website called Box of Truth actually said that no, the grooves do not make them spin at all, and in fact, it's kind of a marketing scam to make customers feel like his slugs would spin. And even on Field and Stream, they titled this "Rifled Slugs Aren't Really Rifled." And they actually came to this conclusion based on a slug that they found where the ribs were all smashed. And I guess since they're calling them veins, they're assuming that the air flowing over the slug is going to make them spin. But of course, the veins would have no effect simply because of the shockwave at the nose. So if a Foster slug is going to spin, it would have to occur while it was traveling down the barrel. With some simple markings on the slugs and a high-speed camera, let's find out what's really going on.
Do Foster slugs actually spin in the air? We're going to find out today. We've got one painted here with some patented Tauflater Mouse racing stripes, and we're going to be sending it through a smoothbore, standard old Federal Foster rifled slug. So let's see if it spins as if it was coming out of a rifled bore.
Oh, he's just petering along. Okay, anytime you're ready.
All right, here we go. Center mass.
Now this is filmed at 8,800 frames per second with the Chronos high-speed camera. The slug is rotating, but ever so slightly. Now the slug is rotating in a clockwise direction, and that matches the angles of the ribs. Now from the time it entered the frame until it hit, it only made one half of a revolution. Is that amount of spin enough to really stabilize it? Okay, hit it!
All right, you can see our laser dot out there.
I see the laser dot.
Broke your block.
Now in this shot I've set the focus ahead of the target so we can get a better view of the slug flying through the air. Again, the slug is rotating in a clockwise direction, and in this amount of space it only rotated 90 degrees, or one quarter of a turn. If there was a Foster slug that had no ribs on it, what would it look like and how would it fly? Well, we're able to show you that. Now Denver from Australia sent us some slugs that are essentially Foster slugs without any rifling at all on them. They're just smooth. Now his slug simply relies on drag stabilization, a very nose-heavy design. So let's see how this slug performs. The Denver Pile Driver from Australia, it is basically an unrifled slug. It will shoot it. We got 23 grains of Hodgkin's Long Shot. So we'll see how that performs. These aren't going to spin at all, so.
Sorry, Carter.
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go. On the laser. Man.
Does that have a good kick to it?
Yeah. I don't think it was quite as bad as that last one, though.
Okay.
On the laser.
So without any spin stabilization at all, the slug performed well. Now this was essentially a test shot just to make sure that my powder load was correct, and it looks like it's good. Now the biggest difference between this and the rifled Foster slug is that we can see the tail end of this kind of wobbling around a little bit. And when we make the final video where we test out Denver's slugs, we'll be able to see if that has any effect on its accuracy. Let's have some more fun with the Foster slugs. Here I have a 1 gallon jug full of water and a whole bunch of junk mail. This is the perfect target, and so satisfying. Oh!
I hope you got that on Chronos.
I would say
oh, yeah.
It went through. Center of that dot.
Oh! The Foster slug by far is the most popular slug that we shoot in the United States. 1 ounce of lead traveling 1,600 feet per second is going to do damage on anything it hits. And you can buy these things at Walmart for about $1 a round. But let's get back to the Foster slug and its rather anemic spin. Is that enough to really do anything? Now you have to consider this is filmed at 8,800 frames per second, and that lead slug is actually spinning several hundred RPM. Now if you believe that that amount of angular momentum is not enough to stabilize something, well consider this. This quarter was filmed at 8,800 frames per second, and it's more than enough spin to keep this quarter from falling over. Now despite what the experts say, a rifled shotgun slug does indeed spin out of a smoothbore shotgun. And the rotation is occurring inside the barrel as the soft lead slug is pressed against the walls of the barrel. There is enough friction there to cause the slug to spin. It's not a very efficient way of causing a spin, but it does occur. Even though the spin isn't very much, it still adds to the slug's overall stability. Hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. Okay, how far will a vest go if you just hit it with a slug? Here's okay, you're good.
Okay, here we go.
Wow.
Okay, here we go.
Wow.
Threw those blocks out there.
Slug wanted to break through on the back. Made a nice little hole in the carrier. And inside here.
There it is.
You can see it. Still warm. Still with Kevlar fibers imprinted on it.
Still has the markings on
it's
there.
Like a tiny little turtle shell.
Oh.